So today I'm going to show you how to set up this simple metallic car paint with some flakes and Blender. Here I got a little toy model where you can see that the car paint consists of two main components, the flakes and the orange peel and the clear coat. So that's what we're going to create today. Just delete the default cube, add a sphere to test the shading. I usually tend to add a plane for the shadow, doesn't really matter much. Add some kind of light source. I usually use HDRs from HDR Haven. Create a material, name it car paint. It's always good to name things. Open up a shader editor. Then we're going to jump right in. So a simple car paint, you're just going to bump up the metallic to 1, change the roughness to 0.4 or 0.5, doesn't matter much. You can bump up the clear coat to 2. So now we've got a simple solid car paint, but we're going to add some flakes. So we're going to add the Voronoi texture, hook it up into the normal input of the principal shader. Of course, we need a bump node to render it correctly. But yeah, now we're going to change the contrast of the bumps. Change the mode of the Voronoi texture to whatever looks good. I usually just play around with it. Bump up the scale of the Voronoi so it looks good. We're going to change the bump to 0.1 so it's not so intense. Now we're going to work on the roughness. So same procedure, basically just play around with the contrast till it looks good. We're going to add a math node. So we got a main slider for the roughness. Since it's plugged in, we don't have the control anymore. So just multiply the whole thing with a certain number. So in this case, I'm using 0.4, 0.5, whatever looks good. So now we can just change up the colors, which works fine. But what I like to do is add some rainbowish sparkly effect to the color. So we're just going to hook up the Voronoi on its own. Of course, it won't work. So we're going to add a mix shader as well. So we can multiply the thing with some color. So just change it to a color for the test, turn it to multiply. 1, of course, won't work. So we're going to use like 0.9 or 0.95, whatever looks good. But you see on 0.9, it's a bit milky. So like 0.95. Now we got this rainbowish look in the flakes, which is very nice. This is also going to be our new control for the color in the future. So anytime you want to change the color, you're going to change it here, as well as the roughness and the bump here. So pretty simple. So next, of course, is the clear coat that's missing. I'm just going to use a glossy shader. I'm just going to mix it up with the principal shader. Usually I tend to use a Fresnel node to mix up the glossy and the principal shader. That's also what I'm going to use here. You could also use the facing node or the layer weight node. It doesn't really matter. So next, we're just going to add the orange peel. We're just going to use a simple noise texture. Hook it up to the normal input of the Fresnel or the glossy. It doesn't matter much, but don't forget the bump node in between, otherwise it won't render correctly. Always plug it into the height input, not into the normal input. That's a common mistake. So we're just going to change the scale to something that looks kind of realistic. I'm just doing this all pretty free-handed, so just by eye. So yeah, now you got a nice normal map and created a nice bump for the orange peel clear coat. And now it's pretty much done. The only thing I'm adding now is a mapping node and a coordinates node. So you got a main control for the whole scaling of the flakes and the clear coat and the orange peel clear coat, of course. Pretty simple. Just changing the scale also just by eye. So it looks okay for this example. But at the end, you're probably going to change it. So here's a default scene of a Mercedes that I created recently with some area lights. We're just going to drop in our sphere. I just copy and pasted it over so we can add the material to the Mercedes. Once we've done that, we're pretty much finished. And then we can just start rendering pretty much. So if you want to change the color, as mentioned, we got this controller here. Just change it to whatever looks good. The C63 often is like in a dark blue metallic. So that's why I'm choosing blue here. Just bumping up the exposure for this example. And then you can pretty much finally render it, throw it into Photoshop, do some color grading, and then you basically come up with this. I'll also make a tutorial on this topic as well next for simple scene setups, but I thought talking about a car paint first makes more sense. So that's it for today. Goodbye.